this, Father. We give you glory. We give you honor. We're here to praise your holy name, Lord. We're here to praise your holy name. We thank you, Father, for all your love. We thank you, Father, tonight for the grace. We thank you, Father, tonight for your mercy. We thank you, Father, tonight for the victories. We thank you, Father, for the healings. We thank you, Father, for the deliverance. We thank you, Father, for being our God. You're everything that we need. You're everything to us. You're almighty, all everything. There's no other like you, Lord. There's no other like you. We're here to give you praise, Father. We're here to give you glory, Father. We're here to give you honor. In Jesus' name, Lord, in Jesus' name. Glory, glory, glory. Bless your holy name. Bless your holy name. You are so worthy of our praise, Lord. You are so worthy of our praise. You are so worthy, Lord. You are so worthy. We praise you, Father. We praise you. We honor you tonight with our presence. We hear because we love you, Father. Glory, glory, glory. We come to say thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Father, for all you're doing. Thank you, Father, for all that you've done. And we thank you, Father, for the things to come. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. There's no other like you, Lord. There's no other like you. Glory, glory, glory. You hear our prayers, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And you answer them, Father. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord, for hearing us. We thank you, Lord, for answering our prayers. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you, Father. Glory, glory, glory. There's no other like you, Lord. There's no other like you. Everything that we have, everything that we do, everything we do in honor of you, Father. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. We trust in you, Father. Our eyes are fixed on you, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. We don't see the world the way the world sees it, Father. We see the world through your eyes, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. We see hope. Glory, glory, glory. We see victories. We see healing. Glory, glory, glory. We see deliverance. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. You're so merciful, Father. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. And we thank you tonight, Father. We thank you tonight. We thank you tonight, Father. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. No weapons, Father. No weapons formed against us shall prosper. Hararasa kandabirete kinder. Horarete kid, varate kinder. Our faith is our shield. Horarase kura varate shan. Ibrese kid, varate kinder. No worries. Hararate kura varate shan. No fears. Hararate kid, varate kinder. Erase all doubt. Hararate kura varate shan. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you for your word, Father. We thank you for your word. For it's food to us. It's life to us. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. It's our guide. It's everything to us, Father. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for your word. We thank you for the promises, Father. And we stand on those promises in Jesus' name. Glory, 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 glory. We lay all of our cares at your feet, Lord. We give it all to you, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Father. We thank you, Father, for taking all of our pain, for taking all of our grief, for taking all of our sickness, for taking all of our diseases. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father, for taking on all of the world's ills. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. You freed us, Father. We've been freed. Glory, glory, glory. Freedom of worship. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. How salvation is of you, Father. We've been redeemed. Glory, glory, glory. You've given us power and authority over the saints. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. May empower us. To be little gods of this world. To do the works that you did, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. Bless your holy name. Bless your holy name. We thank you for your sacrifice. To lay down your life for us. So that we may have life. And have it more abundantly. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Oh, what a God we serve. Oh, what a God we serve. There's no other like you, Lord. There's no other like you. Our King of Kings, our Lord of Lords. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you for this 5-4 ministry, Father. And we thank you tonight. We thank you tonight. We thank you for our pastors, James and Merlin Hill. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you for Pastor Donnell and Sister Candy. Glory, 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 glory. We thank you for our women of excellence, Father. We thank you for our men of honor. We thank you, Father, for our children's ministry. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you tonight for our praise team and our musicians. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you tonight for our technicians and our maintenance. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you for all, Father, who have a hand in this ministry. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. This is our church. Glory, glory, glory. This is our church, but this is the house that you build, Lord. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you for this house, Father. We thank you for this house of prayer. We thank you tonight for these praying sisters and brothers. We thank you for this family, Father. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you tonight. We honor you tonight. We worship you tonight. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. In Jesus' name, Lord. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, about my vision. Even in a second, about my vision. Glory, glory, glory. Our Father, what happened? We thank you for this day. We thank you for the sisters and brothers that's here tonight, Father. We thank you, Lord, for giving us an opportunity to come before you. Your usher in, your love, Horasekid, to be a witness for you, Horasekid. We thank you, Father, for us tonight. Glory, glory, glory. That we come to praise you and honor you and worship you, Father. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you, Lord, for watching over this house, for watching over this family, for watching over this ministry. We thank you tonight, Father. Glory, 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 for watching over our families and all of their children and their children. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We thank you, Father, for the service yesterday. Glory, glory, glory. This house was filled with your presence. The anointing was high. Glory, glory, glory. All of the prayers that went out to you, Father. All the bended knees. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father, for being in the midst of us. We give you praise, we give you glory, and we give you honor. In Jesus' name, Lord, in Jesus' name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. You're so worthy of our praise, Lord. You're so worthy of our praise. We give you praise, Father. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Listen, hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. This is truly the day the Lord has made. Glory, glory, glory. We give us life. You give us joy. You give us peace. Glory, glory, glory. You strengthen us when we're weak. You build us up when we fall down. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father, for showing us the way. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. We say thank you tonight. We say thank you tonight. We say thank you tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're so worthy. You're so worthy. Glory to you. Glory to you. We praise you, Lord. We honor you tonight, Father. Glory to you, Lord. Where would we be without you, Lord? Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. You are our God, Father. You are our Father. We thank you for the fellowship. We thank you for the relationship. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you, Lord, for being in us. You are in you. Glory, glory, glory. We thank you for the right standing, for everything, for this
testimony or anything I'd like to share at this time. Thank you. It's in Psalms 8. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth, who has set their glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings hath thou ordained strength because of thine enemies, that thou might steal the enemy and the avenger. When I consider the heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars, which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou visit him?
Amen.
For thou hast made him a little lower than the angels, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Yes. Thou made him to have dominion over the works of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, yeah, and the beasts of the field, the fowl of the air, and the fish of the sea, and whatsoever passes through the paths of the sea. O Lord our God, how excellent is thy name in all the earth.
Amen.
This was my Bible study. That was one of my things I had to read today, and I thought that
Amen.
We've been given power and authority.
Oh, yes.
We are the gods of this world. We have the right. We've been given that right. Because our righteousness is of Christ. So we have the right, the authority to rule in this world. And to do anything less than that is not a good thing. You know, so we must use everything that Jesus laid his life down for us to have. He did it for us and for us to use. You know, so when you're feeling down, when you're feeling low, and the world is coming against you, Jesus already given you everything you need to fight back, to withstand the devil.
Amen.
We are not defeated. We are not to be defeated.
Right.
Amen. As long as we have that authority, we have the power.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you again, Sister Shirley. That was good.
Yes.
Love it.
All right. So anybody else have something like that before I turn it over to Pastor?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. I just like to comment on the service yesterday. It was very powerful. Very powerful. This church was so much anointing that was in here. It was just spirit filled. And to see all of you come forward and bend your knees the way you did. That was God. It wasn't about us. It was about Him.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Amen. You know, so whatever come out of that, only good things could come out of that. And I'm sure that your lives from yesterday to today has been different.
Yes.
It's been good. It's been blessed. There's been joy in your life. And that's just not in the last 24 hours. You can expect that now to be that way every day. Be that way every day. Yeah. This is the way God intended for us to be. To be full of joy, full of life, peaceful.
Yes.
Not fearing, not worrying,
yes.
Not
yes.
Doubting.
That's right.
Yes, go ahead.
That guy came yesterday with my daughter's friend.
Yes.
He said that he was going to come back. He said, you know, Miss Brown said, I don't want to go to church. She said, but Sharita was telling him about our church. Uh-huh. And he said he was coming back. He got there kind of late.
Yeah.
I don't really forget, but he said he'll be back.
Mm-hmm. The one that came to the altar?
I don't know. Did he go to the
altar?
Yeah.
Did he? Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes, it did.
Yeah.
He said he'd be back.
Praise God.
I don't even know his name. I just know he's Sharika's friend.
His name is Steve Hill.
Steve Hill. Okay. You know him?
No, I went to school with him. Excuse me. Are you ready, Castillo?
Guess so.
Couldn't get the car to his bike to work tonight, so wired it in.
These are just scriptures that shows that God says that my ears ain't heavy, my arms are not short that I can't say, right? My ears heavy that I can hear, but it's our iniquity that have separated us. It's things that comes between us and God, the things that stifles our joy and that hinders the flow of praise and worship from amen, from flowing from our hearts. Amen. And so let's look at Psalms 18. All right, Sister Bill, would you help me with that? Psalms 18.
18, 24.
Therefore, 20, okay, go ahead.
Therefore hath the Lord recompensed me according to my righteousness, according to the With thee merciful, thou wilt show thyself merciful. With an upright man, thou wilt show thyself upright. With the pure, thou wilt show thyself pure. And with the forward, thou wilt show thyself forward.
Okay. So this scripture is showing that God's rewards and blessings are according to the cleanness of our hands. So that motivates us to eliminate from our lives and our minds and our lives the everything that will hinder or prevent us from offering God the blessing, I mean the praise and the worship that He desires. Amen. So how many know that things that we think about, things that happen to us during the day, and things that we experience sometimes can prevent God from flowing and God from working? So we want to, this week while fasting and praying, we want to ask God to search us and remove from our hearts and our lives everything that is hindering us or preventing us. Sometimes it might be worry, sometimes it might be fear or anxiety. Sometimes it might be different things that's going on in relationships and so forth and so on. But David prayed the prayer in Psalms. He says, Lord, create in me. Is that right? Lord, have mercy upon me according to your loving kindness.
Yes.
Blot out all of my blood transgressions. Amen. If we don't have the joy, there is something that's hindering the joy from flowing. If we don't have that peace, if we don't have that victory, amen, there is something that is hindering that from being released from within. Amen. How many want to have clean hands?
Amen.
Pure heart. Amen. God rewards people according to the cleanness of their hands.
Yes.
Amen. And He withholds blessings. Amen. When we don't have clean hands and clean hearts. All right. Jeremiah 5:25 shows that God will behold blessings. Amen. It doesn't take a whole lot for us to lose our joy, our strength. Amen. Jeremiah 5:25. All right, I'll tell Brother Chandler to turn his hair on in 90 minutes. I used to do all of that. I used to have to think about every service. And I got to turn the hair on. So when y'all are in charge, the responsibility is on you. All right, somebody read Jeremiah 5:25. How is it?
Do it. Iniquity shall turn away these things, and your sins thou withholdest good things from you.
Okay. What does that say? 5:25. It says what? Your
yes, iniquity shall turn away.
All right, that's it.
Okay. The iniquity shall turn away.
Okay. All right. Your iniquities have turned away these things, and your sins have withholden good things from you. So it's kind of difficult to get over many times what sin is, because many times sin is something that the other person does, and not me. But when sin, when we say sin, we start looking around. Who was he talking about? Couldn't be talking about me. Well, scripture says he that committed sin, whosoever transgresses the law, sin is a transgression of what? God's law. Amen. Sin is a transgression of God's law. And the scripture also said all unrighteousness is what? Sin. That's two definitions. And how many can count pretty good? One, two. Sin is transgression. Would you do something that God said to do, or would you fail to do what God told you to do? God tells you to praise Him with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and when you hold back because of your feelings, because of what you're going through, because of what you're dealing with, you're withholding from God the thing that's doing you. And you're withholding from people. Amen. The scripture says, don't withhold good from them to whom it is due when it is in the power of your hand what to do it. Many times we hold back in praise and worship, and that's causing many of us to not receive what we need to be receiving from the Lord. Amen. We have to understand what the will of the Lord is. The will of the Lord is for us to come and to worship. You know, as I said yesterday, Philippians 3:3, we the circumcision, we all the same, we call the saved ones of the Lord, the circumcised, the clean ones. We worship the Lord in the Spirit. Amen. Everybody said we're supposed to worship the Lord in the Spirit.
Worship the Lord in the Spirit.
And rejoice in Jesus Christ. Amen. That's the second thing we're to do. Rejoice in Jesus Christ. And what? Have no confidence in the flesh. Amen. So God will hold blessings from us when we fail to rejoice, when we fail to, amen, worship the Lord in the Spirit, when we do it half-heartedly, when we do it grudgingly, when we do it from, sometimes we have to, what, pull the praises out, it's, you know, really admonish people to praise. But God does not want us to praise Him reluctantly or against our will. It's supposed to be something that we offer God freely. Amen. Praise God. You know, a lot of people can get blessed when we get our minds off of our problems, circumstances, what we're going through, what we don't have. Amen. And all of the things that hinder us, amen, from bringing our spirits into harmony with our souls and bodies. Amen. So God can be magnified and God can be worshipped like He wants to be worshipped. Amen. So that's the reason why many blessings are withheld, because God wants us to serve Him out of what? Our whole heart, with our whole heart. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, okay, okay, so start.
Philippians 4, could you explain that?
Philippians 4?
3:4.
Okay, Philippians 3:4. All right. Sister Bill, if you're there, explain it to him. All right, Philippians 3. Mm-hmm. Though I might have also confidence in my flesh, if any man, other man thinking that he had whereof he might trust in the flesh, I more. Okay, circumcised the eighth day of the stock of Israel. Paul was just kind of enumerating the reasons why he would have grounds to boast if he was going to do it in his flesh. All of his credentials, all of his past experience, and all that he had done that was honorable in the sight of man. But later on he said, but I count all of these things that I have gained as what? Loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord. That's basically what he was speaking about. Okay, we back at that first scripture, God rewards and blesses our according to the cleanness of our hands. And we read that scripture, okay? I want to read Psalms 51, because we're going to be fasting, we're going to be praying, and we want to make sure that everything that is going to be a hindrance is going to be eliminated from our lives. Otherwise, it's just a waste of time to go through all that we do, and our hearts are not really right with God. If there's any sin, if there's any iniquity, if there's anything that's hindering us from having a clear conscience, toward God and toward man. Amen. This is the week that we need to lay all of these things aside. The scripture says, have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness. This is Psalms 51. According unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity. Iniquity are just sins that we premeditate, things that we plan to do that's wrong. So the scripture says we're not to make any provisions for the flesh to what? Fulfill the desires thereof. Amen. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions and my sin is ever before me. And he goes on, verse 11, 10, create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. Then will I teach transgressors thy way, and sinners will be converted unto thee. Amen. This is the sign that we have been restored, and when every sin, everything has been completely eliminated and put away. Amen. Scripture says, then I will teach transgressors thy way. You can't teach transgressors God's way until you get yourself what? In line. Amen. Sinners shall be converted unto thee. Amen. The passion and the longing to see others saved is something that will begin to automatically, amen, it will automatically return. Amen. So this is what, all right, now let's look at verse 17. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. Amen. I doubt very seriously whether we really make the proper connection while when we pray, unless we come to a point of brokenness. Amen. Until we come to a point of brokenness, I mean, point that you're dead serious, that you come to the end of yourself and you let go and you let God. That's the place of brokenness. That's the thing that gets God's attention. The sacrifices of God are a what? Broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. Amen. So we're going to ask God this week to give us a spirit of brokenness. Yes. Yes. Amen. When we weep, cry, repent, turn to God with all our hearts. Amen. Open up so everything that's not pleasing to God is completely released. All of our sins are gone. Then nobody have to pet. Nobody have to howl aloud to try to get you free. You automatically begin to what? Release the joy of the Lord. Amen. The joy of the Lord will be your strength. Amen. How many want to be like God wants you to be?
Yes.
Amen. Amen. When God releases you, there's going to be joy. Amen. There's going to be what? Joy unspeakable. Hallelujah. So God's rewards and blessings are according to the cleanness of our hands. And turn back to page 12. I want you to read this whole thing. And maybe 11 at the bottom. Moral purity. Joseph is said to have the purest character known in history for the Lord, except for the Lord Jesus. Amen. Joseph is said to have had the purest character known in history except for the Lord Jesus. A clean heart and clean hands throughout his life differentiate him from great men as Moses, David, Solomon. All of these men were great men, but they've had some what? Some pretty colorful history.
Yes.
We know about Moses, amen. I don't consider Moses thing, you know, as being something that is not common to most men. David, we know his sin. What was his sin? It was adultery. What was Moses' sin? You know, big God, right? God told him to what? Smite them. Speak to the rock, and he what? Yeah, okay. He had, right, his past was full of him, and there was sin in his past. You know, so, but Joseph, you can't hardly find anything that links him to any kind of sin that he ever committed. So he had a pure heart, a perfect being almost. Amen. We know the story of Solomon, right? We know Solomon what? He had all of these concubines and wives. 300 or 700?
700.
So he was full of lust, wasn't he? Well, he was the greatest, one of the greatest kings. Amen. One point, God used him. The first 20 years of his life, he was on fire. Amen. And Paul. Now, Joseph was, Paul had a bad history. Amen. But when he persecuted the Christians and all of that. But Joseph was a man that we don't find any dark marks against him. He was marked as a type of Christ in the following ways: his trials, resistance to temptation, degradation, his exaltation, saving his people, confusing his enemies. The scripture teaches that the Lord rewards men for doing right and being pure. And we can see how God rewarded Joseph. He rewarded him big time. All right, let's look at Joseph's moral purity is seen in the following experiences during his life. He didn't hold animosity nor resentment against his brothers who despised him, mistreated him, and sold him. So this is a type of character we are trying to attain unto. He puts us into a realm where God can really pull out his fullness upon our lives. You know, there's not a lot God can do when we got a lot going on in our lives. When we are doing things knowingly that this pleases the Lord. Amen. And so he didn't hold animosity nor resentment against his brothers who despised him, mistreated him, and sold him. Yesterday when I was ministering to those young teenagers, preteens, they didn't understand why Joseph was so much different than his brothers until we explained to them that he was raised in a home where it was several wives, and Jacob had how many wives? He had two, Leah and who? Rachel. And he also had children by his what? His handmaidens. I mean, the maidservants. So it was at least four mothers living in the same house, under the same roof, and all of them were vying for attention, for Joseph's attention. There's a lot of contention. And Jacob, everybody, you know, all of them were what? Fighting and squabbling and resenting and hating each other. And those boys came up in that type of environment. You can imagine the animosity and the revenge and all of the hate, the envy and mess that these boys were filled with because they were exposed to that in their home. Amen. But Joseph was the one that was different, and he received the word of God. And whatever the word commanded him to do, he was the one that what? Gave heed to the word of God. He attended unto the word. Whatever the word commanded him to do, whatever the word said, do. Amen. And he received his teaching, I'm sure, from his father. Some give heed and some don't give heed. Is that right? Some listen and some don't listen. Some the word never seems to find its rightful place in their life, and some people do hearken diligently and try to do all that God has what? Spoken through his word. And for those that will hearken diligently to do all that God has commanded, you know, through the grace of God, amen, those are the ones that God is not going to withhold any good thing. amen, from those that will completely, amen, surrender unto him. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
All right, so y'all can see why Joseph was honored of God and why he was so blessed, because he didn't hold any kind of what? Resentment, animosity, and mess. Amen. Although his brothers, what, despised him, mistreated him, and sold him, they hated him. Amen. But yet, amen, he what? He treated them in love. He walked in love. Amen. God can bless people like that, can't
he?
Amen. All right. He resisted temptations and enticements in the idolatrous land of Egypt, rejected the evil advances of Potiphar's wife. Y'all know what that's all about. Amen. He went through all of that, and he was imprisoned because of that temptation that he resisted, caused him is what? Caused him to lose his freedom and his liberty and his position in Potiphar's house. But was he bitter? No. He went on to prison, and God raised him up down there as the head of the prison. Amen. God rewards people for doing right and for being what? Pure.
Amen.
Sister Marion might want one of these. All right? An excellent spirit, an excellent attitude demonstrated in his relationship with others while serving Potiphar and doing his unpleasant experiences of cruelty in prison. Amen. An excellent attitude. Although he had been lied on, he ended up in prison, but he demonstrated an excellent attitude. And those in prison, he ministered. Amen. And because he ministered to those in prison, he gave him the occasion. The occasion came that he was released from prison because of the ministry that he had ministered to one of the men that had the dream. That's the thing that got him out of prison. Amen. They kept pushing him down, but he kept bouncing up. Amen. Anybody ever seen a beach ball trying to put it under, push it down underneath the water? Amen. I don't care how much pressure you exert to that beach ball, it always what? Popped back up. That's the way Joseph was. That's the way God wants you to be. Amen. He wants you to pop up every time somebody try to what? Push you down. Do your own. Hallelujah. Every time you face temptation, amen, and the enemy tries to what? Knock you out of the game. Amen. But God keeps what? Amen. Causing you to come back up. He failed to hold grudges, revenge, and hostility toward brothers. Now, all of this is holiness. Now, this is how we're supposed to be living our lives. If you really want the blessings of the Lord to flow, we're going to have to what? Live like the Word says live. Amen. I'm willing to pay the price. I'm willing to ball and squall until God can get out of me everything that needs to be out of me. Amen. If the Lord will show you something wrong with you, amen, let him help you to get rid of it.
Yes.
Amen. How many can tell when the Lord is showing you yourself? Amen. Praise God. All right. Grudges, revenge, and hostility toward brothers during years of famine. You know, all of that hostility and revenge and all of the crazy, stupid things that they did. They lied. Amen. Time and time again, they tried to make their father believe that Joseph was what, destroyed by some wild beast. That poor man, for 13 years, even got gray-headed. He just worried himself to death because them boys had given him the impression that what, Joseph had been killed. And all the time, they knew that Joseph weren't dead, had been killed. They didn't kill him, right? They drew him up out of the pit. Amen. And while he was in the pit, they sat down and had a party. I mean, they were cold-blooded. They were cold-hearted. Amen. But they sold him for 20 pieces of silver. And that's where he ended up, down in Egypt, as Potiphar's servant. But he became the top dog. Everything Potiphar had, he turned it over to Joseph. He was in control. And the Bible says God blessed the house of Potiphar for Joseph's sake. God caused everything he touched, amen, it turned to gold.
I wonder how did their brothers feel when they in the bet you didn't pack right with a felony.
All right, I don't know how you could describe how they felt. They felt like, they felt very cheap.
Cheap, yeah.
They felt like.
Probably he was dead by now, but.
They felt like, I mean, they felt like two pennies. All right. But Joseph held his cool. He didn't have no animosity and no grudges, no revenge. After all of those years, amen. God was what? Constantly elevating you. He was just going higher, 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 higher. See, God will elevate you if you what? If you will. The Bible says, he that humbleth himself shall be what? Exalted. So that's the reason why we want to get everything right. Everything out of our life. All of the drawback, all of the reservations we have in terms of approaching God and worshiping God and letting go and letting God. We want to get rid of all of that so God can be all that he wants to be in our hearts and in our lives. How many can say amen?
Amen.
I want you to just read this and just, this will be a real blessing to you because 12 things the scripture teach about purity and holiness. And you will be blessed if you just go down this list and just look up those scriptures and you'll see the type of environment and the type of heart and the type of situation. God will actually reward and God will cause his blessings to be poured out upon your life. Amen. So I felt that this scripture, I mean these set of scriptures were scriptures that we were dealing with on page 14, admonitions to purity and holiness in our daily lives. You have so many scriptures. Amen. Talking about be holy, be holy, be holy, be holy. Amen. So this means not only staying away or removing yourself from things which are ungodly or becoming partakers of other men's sins and having nothing to do with the unfruitful work of darkness. But a lot of it has to do with ridding yourself of things that's hindering you that pertains to your flesh. Amen. Your drawback spirit. Amen. How we spend our time. Things we do for God. Attitudes that we have toward God and to people. And pride. Sometimes we feel like we got it all and we just don't exert too much but effort to, amen, to worship God like he what plainly tells us to do it. Amen. So we just want to get in line the best we can. And I believe as we get in line and lay aside every hindrance and the sin which does so easily beset us, then I believe the blessings, amen, the glory and the honor of purity and holiness will begin to be released into our lives. Amen. So I just want everybody to spend this time, this week, meditating scriptures that pertain to God's will for us to be holy and without blame. Amen. And to have our love, to make ourselves a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is our reasonable service. Amen.
Amen.
We just want everybody to lift your hearts this evening, and we just want God to really begin to anoint us to go through these few days of fasting. First day or two, you might want to do fruit juices and go light. But at the end, amen, we want to see how far you can go, how strong you are, and how willing you are to suffer. We want you to go just with water. Everybody just said with water.
With water.
And I don't think anybody's going to die. Amen. If you take the medication, amen. If you're not going to die, drink condom water, you'll be all right. All right, so I want everybody to open up your heart this evening. And I want you to just purpose in your heart that you're just going to let go this week and just let God give you a good release, a good breakthrough in the spirit this week. I want everybody to open up your heart this evening. Amen. And just, I want you to pray from your heart. God says, sing in the spirit of God, says, pray in the Holy Ghost. However the Spirit of God leads us, that's what we want to do this evening. Amen. I believe the joy of the Lord can be our strength. How many know the joy of the Lord is our strength? And although we are tired, the Bible says, let the weak say, I'm strong. Amen. I can do all things through Christ that what strengthens me. You can talk your way into strength just by what? Let words which pertains to the strength of God, let those words begin to what? Flow from your mouth. Amen. Praise God. How many can say, greater is he that is in me that is in the world? Christ is in me. He doeth the work. He is my salvation. He is my strength. He is the joy. He's the light of my salvation. He's the strength of my life. Hallelujah. Come on, just lift your hearts to Spirit. Oh, Lord, we thank you for the name of the whole church. Lord, you are working in me, and you are greater than all. Lord, I want to reach my potential in you. Oh, God, if I continue to live my life according to the way I feel like I should live, Lord, I will always, in every case, fall short. Oh, God, yes. Lord, you say if we be pure and holy, that you will reveal to us your secrets. The deep things of the Holy Spirit, Lord, you said you would reveal. Joseph, he had a great revelation because an excellent spirit that was in him. He understood the deep things of God. God revealed Pharaoh's dreams. Lord, you said you reveal your secrets to your people. Yes, those that fear you, those that walk before you with all of their hearts. You said you won't withhold no good thing from them. Yes, Lord. Lord, you can make me all that I need to be. What I need, Lord. Hey, hallelujah. Lord, the deep things of God. Lord, the revelation knowledge. Hey, yes, teaching transgressors your way. Yes, causing sinners to be converted unto you, Lord. When we come to the place where our lives are lights, yes, and we are the salt of the earth. Hey, and when we can say, I am complete in you. Hey, when we let go and let God. Oh, God, then you can be all that you need to be. Hey, you can make us all that we need to be, Lord, want to be. Hallelujah. Oh, God, Lord, help me to overcome. Yay. Every hindrance that's keeping me from receiving the best that you have for me. Hey, reveal to me, Lord, where I'm missing it in every area of my life. Hey, Lord, I don't want to be on the side, man. I don't want to be distracted. Hey, Lord, I want to follow you. Where you lead me, I will follow. Oh, God, Lord, in the last days, just before Jesus comes, raise every one of us up. Lord, whatever we need to get straight, Lord, help us to get it straight quickly, because you're to come soon. Oh, God, those works that you are expected to find when we come, Lord, we want those works, to glorify you at your return. Lord, help us in this last hour. Help us to realize how dark it is, how dim the light is all around us, and how close we are. Hey, how close we are to the coming of the Lord. Oh, God, the time is so short. What we must do it quickly. Hey, hallelujah. Lord, cleanse me and make me all that I need to be. Hey, blot out every transgression, Lord. Hey, every place that every way that I have missed you, Lord. Oh, God, keep me on the straight and narrow path. Yes, in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Oh, we ban the works of the sin, the works of Satan. Oh, he comes to steal. He comes to heal. He comes to destroy. But Jesus, you've come that we might have life. Lord, cleanse us from all of the works of the flesh, perfected holiness in the fear of God. All of the works of the flesh, sins of temperament, sins of sexual sins, Hey, lustful sins. Hey, sins of intemperance. Yes, sins of pride. Hey, hallelujah. Oh, sins of complacency. Oh, God, hallelujah. Oh, God, stir us in this last hour. Stir us. Hey, raise us up. Hey, Jesus' name, Jesus' name, Jesus' name, Jesus' name. Oh, we ban the works of sin, works of Satan. Hey, hey, Lord, we release your anointing to help. Your grace is sufficient. Hey, your grace is sufficient today. Your grace is sufficient. Your grace is sufficient, Lord. Yes, to break the hold of whatever is, yes, hanging over my life. Whatever fleshly work, hey, that's trying to latch on, that's trying to hold on, that's trying to prevent me, yes, from rising up in God and finishing my course and carrying out the will of God. Whatever work it is, whatever work of the flesh it is, we ban that work. We ban the spirit. Hey, we ban that spirit right now. Hey, hallelujah, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, you said the joy of the Lord is our strength. As we rejoice, as we give you the glory, Lord, you said you will forgive all of our sin. You will break the dominion of spiritual death. You will break the dominion of Satan. You will break the dominion of our flesh as we begin to praise you, as we begin to lift up our hearts and worship you in the beauty of holiness. Lord, we thank you. I say to this evening, no weapon formed against me will prosper. No weapon formed against me will prosper. Oh, God. I'm only just saying he shut up. All the sacrifices of God. All the sacrifices of God. Oh, we will circumcise and worship the Lord in the Spirit. Yes, we rejoice in Jesus Christ. We have no confidence. Oh, we will not let our mind. We will not let our flesh call the shots. We will not just let our flesh. Hey, hey, prevail. We go beyond the barrier. Beyond how we feel, beyond how we have, how we have done it in the past. Lord, we lift up our hearts tonight, Lord. Break me and make me and shape me, Lord, the way I need to be. Hey,
hallelujah.
Hey, hallelujah.
Come
on, hold on my heart, shut up my heart, my heart.
Thank you,
Lord. Come on, Lord, shut up my heart, tire. Come on, let's get scared of the whole shot of God. Let's worship him tonight. Let's worship him. Let's worship him. Let's get in the shandala moshekila. Zivi ishekila wabaho. Lemantan lokosanda. Speak unto yourselves. Speak unto yourselves. In songs, hymns, and spiritual songs. Making melodies in your hearts, the Lord. Hey, lalabaho shata. Come on, lalabaho shata.
If you can't pray. Shanda. With your hearts tonight, in the name of God.
Oh, let's worship him.
I'm free, I'm free, I'm free. Oh, ba 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 ba. He the Son set free. He's free. Hey, I'm free. Hey, hey, I'm free. Yeah, hey, I'm free. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
God is honoring. He's honoring that prayer. Shay, shay.
Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray that mighty name of that prayer on your heart. Pray in the Holy Ghost. That prayer in your heart. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Hey, oh, oh, oh. God's approval is on that prayer. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray according to the will of God. Oh, everybody, everybody, lift your voices, lift your voices. Come on, lift your voices. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the Holy Ghost. All of our lost loved ones, we put them on the altar. Love, 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 love,